2018 Mercedes-Benz GLS-class infotainment review. Don't let the 12-button number pad fool you. The GLS-class can be outfitted with the latest version of Mercedes COMAND infotainment system. It's mostly a successful application, although the touchpad can impede access to the rotary dial. What's new for 2018? The bones of the GLS-class's infotainment offerings are unchanged for 2018. Apple CarPlay and Android Auto are now both available, but we'd like to see them as standard in a vehicle this expensive. If a Volkswagen Golf can do it, so should a Mercedes. Infotainment features: the standard infotainment system is bare bones compared with the setups in other luxury vehicles. Access to SiriusXM satellite radio, navigation services, voice commands, and the new touchpad are all limited to the upgraded infotainment system, which is standard in the GLS 550, but only available as part of a $3,830 premium package in the GLS 450. The base system retains the 8.0-inch screen, two USB ports, and Bluetooth connectivity. All Mercedes owners have remote access to their vehicles via a smartphone app, which can remotely start a paired vehicle and either begin heating or cooling the cabin. Drivers who pay for the full suite of COMAND services can also remotely access information about their vehicle's location, mileage, tire pressure, and whether the windows are up or down. Infotainment performance: the COMAND system responded quickly to inputs during our tests, beating the response times of popular smartphones. The competition is serious in this class, though, so COMAND's strong performance does not set it apart from the crowd. Test results: infotainment response time. By filming the infotainment screen while switching between various menus and then analyzing the high-speed video frame by frame, we are able to accurately measure the system's response time. We rate infotainment response, or latency, on the following scale.